Researchers have finally discovered what the purpose of the Easter Island statues are, and I'm going to tell you everything you need to know right now on IO. What is happening, potato people? This is InformOverload, I'm Charlotte Dobry, and if you need a place to get your news on YouTube and you don't mind being called a potato, smash the subscribe and notification bell, and why don't you follow us on Instagram while you're at it. On Easter Island, a remote Chilean island in the southeastern Pacific Ocean, there are around 900 statues called Moai. These statues were created by the Rapu Nui people. The exact reason why there are so many of these ancient statues was debated in the scientific community for centuries. Experts believe that Polynesians landed on Easter Island around the year 1200 AD. The culture was rich and thriving. At its height, there may have been as many as 20,000 people living on Easter Island. But eventually, the Rapu Nui people were wiped out. The reasons for this range from deforestation to the introduction of the Polynesian rat. It was more a combination of a few things. Trees on the island were cut down to build canoes and also transport the statues. But then there weren't any trees. When the Europeans got there in 1722, there were only around 2,000 to 3,000 aboriginals living on the island. By 1877, the small population dwindled to no more than 111 people, thanks to European diseases and slave raiding. But the Moai statues remained to this day. Not much is known about why these elaborate statues were placed all over Easter Island, but they are evidence of a rich culture. What we do know is most of the statues are located on the coast of the island, and an exact reason for that has been discovered. Researchers from Binghamton University and New York State University have an explanation for why the Easter Island statues were placed along the island's coast. On Easter Island, there's very little fresh water. Easter Island is made up of volcanic soil, which incidentally absorbs rain. This means there aren't many rivers or streams on Easter Island because rainwater is absorbed by the porous soil. There are a couple of lakes on the island, but they're hard to get to, and a lot of the time they're reduced to being boggy marshes. Not good for drinking water. I mean, I don't know about you, but I don't like my water with a side of bug larvae and scum, but that's just me. To top everything off, Easter Island only gets around 49 inches of rainfall every year, and a lot of the water evaporates due to the climate. Because of this, the people that lived on Easter Island probably relied on groundwater. And according to these researchers, the statues were placed to mark the location of fresh groundwater. According to professor of anthropology at Binghamton University, Carl Lippo, water beneath the ground of Easter Island flows downhill, and ultimately exits the ground directly at the point at which the porous subterranean rock meets the ocean. When the tides are low, this results in the flow of fresh water directly into the sea. People can then take advantage of these sources of fresh water by capturing the water at these points, which are marked by the Easter Island statues. So cool. I love anthropology. I could talk about this all day long. The first accounts from Europeans who landed on Easter Island said that the islanders appear to drink seawater. Last time I checked, humans can't drink seawater. Our bodies can't process it. I like how I looked at my wrist for that. Researchers believe that these accounts are a reference to the groundwater discharge on the island coast. The fact that the Rapu Nui people were able to cultivate fresh drinking water in this way is a pretty amazing thing. I mean, we knew that they had a rich culture, but the fact that they were able to achieve this level of engineering is, like, remarkable and according to Lippo, this information ultimately sheds light on the conditions that drove and enabled these communities to work together to achieve their feats of engineering. There's still a couple of questions that need answers. Like, how the heck did these aboriginals build these statues and place them in these specific places? Each of the statues weighs 12 metric tons, and they were transported across long distances. And there's almost 1,000 of them. And many of them also have these, like, gigantic stone hats on top of them. Earlier this year, the way that these people placed the stone hats on the statues was discovered also by experts at Binghamton University. It's believed that the rocks were taken from the quarry. They then use a method called parbuckling that involves the use of ropes and a ramp, where a line is wrapped around the cylinder, and the hat was pulled using the rope from the top of the platform. But now we know exactly why the Rapu Nui people placed these statues where they did. This research was published in the Hydrogeology Journal. Alrighty guys, that is all I have for you on that. It is comment time! Easter Island statue videos make me really happy. So Lynn said, now she really looks like Miss Honey in that dress. I have heard that before and I am not mad. Stranded Starfish said, bring back the cute blazers and crop tops. So cute. It's actually gotten quite a bit colder in Toronto since I was wearing those outfits, but maybe I'll wear a blazer and a crop top tomorrow just for you. Meme God said, yeah, oh my god, you deserve more subscribers. I mean, I say this every day. Kayala said, main host, I'm dying. Charlotte carries this channel on her back. Yes, and it is very heavy. Maybe I should use the parbuckling method. Har har har. Yes, I just made an anthropology joke. Somebody stop me. Street Street said, this is the best channel on YouTube. No, you. You're the best channel on YouTube. Welcome to the end screen. This means the video is over. Don't you worry though, there's another great IO video right over here for you to check out. And if you enjoyed your time here, make sure you smash the like, subscribe, and notification bell, and I will see you in a future IO video.